Hey guys, welcome to the Science Fact Channel. Today I have prepared for you facts about physics. So grab your favorite snacks and drinks and get comfortable. Here we go. Let's start with the uncertainty principle. The uncertainty principle, formulated by Werner Heisenberg, states that certain pairs of physical properties cannot be simultaneously known precisely. In everyday life, calculating the speed and position of a moving object is relatively straightforward. We can measure a car traveling at 60 miles per hour or a tortoise crawling at 0.5 miles per hour and simultaneously pinpoint where the objects are located. But in the quantum world of particles, making these calculations is not possible due to a fundamental mathematical relationship called the uncertainty principle. Formulated by the German physicist and Nobel laureate Werner Heisenberg in 1927, the uncertainty principle states that we cannot know both the position and speed of a particle, such as a photon or electron, with perfect accuracy. The more we nail down the particle's position, the less we know about its speed and vice versa. In other words, if we could shrink a tortoise down to the size of an electron, we would only be able to precisely calculate its speed or its location, not both at the same time. Though the Heisenberg uncertainty principle is famously known in quantum physics, a similar uncertainty principle also applies to problems in pure math and classical physics. Basically, any object with wave-like properties will be affected by this principle. Quantum objects are special because they all exhibit wave-like properties by the very nature of quantum theory. To understand the general idea behind the uncertainty principle, think of a ripple in a pond. To measure its speed, we would monitor the passage of multiple peaks and troughs. The more peaks and troughs that pass by, the more accurately we would know the speed of a wave, but the less we would be able to say about its position. The location is spread out among the peaks and troughs. Conversely, if we wanted to know the exact position of one peak of a wave, we would have to monitor just one small section of the wave and would lose information about its speed. In short, the uncertainty principle describes a trade-off between two complementary properties, such as speed and position. The second law of thermodynamics states that the entropy, disorder, of a closed system tends to increase over time. The second law of thermodynamics states that the total entropy of a system either increases or remains constant in any spontaneous process, it never decreases. An important implication of this law is that heat transfers energy spontaneously from higher to lower temperature objects, but never spontaneously in the reverse direction. This is because entropy increases for heat transfer of energy from hot to cold. Let's move on to quantum field theory. Quantum field theory provides a framework for combining quantum mechanics and special relativity. Quantum field theory, QFT, is the mathematical and conceptual framework for contemporary elementary particle physics. It is also a framework used in other areas of theoretical physics, such as condensed matter physics and statistical mechanics. Quantum field theory has been successful in predicting the behavior of particles at the subatomic level. However, it is still an incomplete theory, as it does not take into account the effects of gravity. The search for a theory that unifies quantum field theory and gravity is one of the biggest challenges in modern physics. Fields and particles are the building blocks of everything that exists in the universe. Understanding their behavior and interactions is essential in understanding the fundamental nature of the universe. Quantum field theory provides a framework for studying these concepts, and its continued development is crucial in advancing our understanding of the universe. Next, we're gonna talk about magnetars. Magnetars are neutron stars with extremely powerful magnetic fields, trillions of times stronger than Earth's magnetic field. The magnetic field decay powers the emission of high-energy electromagnetic radiation, particularly X-rays and gamma rays. The existence of magnetars was proposed in 1992 by Robert Duncan and Christopher Thompson. Their proposal sought to explain the properties of transient sources of gamma rays, now known as soft gamma repeaters, SGRs. Over the following decade, the Magnetar hypothesis became widely accepted and was extended to explain anomalous X-ray pulsars, AXPs. As of July 2021, 24 confirmed Magnetars were known. It has been suggested that Magnetars are the source of fast radio bursts, FRB, in particular as a result of findings in 2020 by scientists using the Australian Square Kilometre Array Pathfinder, RSCAP, radio telescope. Like other neutron stars, Magnetars are around 20 kilometers, 12 miles, in diameter, and have a mass of about 1.4 solar masses. They are formed by the collapse of a star with a mass 10 to 25 times that of the Sun. The density of the interior of a Magnetar is such that a tablespoon of its substance would have a mass of over 100 million tons. Before we get to the fifth fact, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you want to see even more interesting facts about science. The Casimir effect is a force that arises from quantum fluctuations of the electromagnetic field between closely spaced conductive plates. The Casimir effect is a small attractive force that acts between two close parallel uncharged conducting plates. It is caused by quantum vacuum fluctuations of the electromagnetic field. The effect was predicted by the Dutch physicist Hendrik Casimir in 1948. According to quantum theory, the vacuum contains virtual particles which are in a continuous state of fluctuation. Casimir realized that between two plates, only those virtual photons whose wavelengths fit a whole number of times into the gap should be counted when calculating the vacuum energy. The energy density decreases as the plates are moved closer together, which implies that there is a small force drawing them together. The tiny force was measured in 1996 by Stephen Lamoureux. His results were in agreement with the theory to within the experimental uncertainty of 5%. Particles other than the photon also contribute a small effect, but only the photon force is measurable. All bosons such as photons produce an attractive Casimir force, whereas fermions make a repulsive contribution. If electromagnetism were supersymmetric, fermionic photinos would exist, whose contribution would exactly cancel that of the photons, so there would be no Casimir effect. The fact that the Casimir effect exists shows that if supersymmetry exists in nature, it must be a broken symmetry. According to the theory, the total zero-point energy in the vacuum is infinite when summed over all the possible photon modes. The Casimir effect comes from a difference of energies in which the infinities cancel. The energy of the vacuum is a puzzle in theories of quantum gravity since it should act gravitationally and produce a large cosmological constant, causing space-time to curl up. The solution to the inconsistency is expected to be found in a theory of quantum gravity. Did you know? The W and Z bosons are responsible for mediating the weak nuclear force, responsible for processes such as beta decay. The W boson is a fundamental particle. Together with the Z boson, it is responsible for the weak force, one of four fundamental forces that govern the behavior of matter in our universe. Particles of matter can interact by exchanging these bosons, but only over short distances. CERN announced the discovery of the W boson on the 25th of January 1983. Two collaborations, UA1, led by Carlo Rubbia, and UA2 led by Pierre Darrielat, presented their observation in seminars a few days earlier. The discovery was due to an idea that Rubbia and others had presented, converting the SPS into a proton-antiproton collider with the necessary energy to produce the W boson. As a result, Rubbia and van der Meer received the Nobel Prize in Physics in 1984. Let's move on to the next fact, and talk about the Compton effect. It demonstrates the particle-like behavior of light and the scattering of photons by charged particles. The Compton effect is the term used for an unusual result observed when X-rays are scattered on some materials. By classical theory, when an electromagnetic wave is scattered off atoms, the wavelength of the scattered radiation is expected to be the same as the wavelength of the incident radiation. Contrary to this prediction of classical physics, observations show that when X-rays are scattered off some materials, such as graphite, the scattered X-rays have different wavelengths from the wavelength of the incident X-rays. This classically unexplainable phenomenon was studied experimentally by Arthur H. Compton and his collaborators, and Compton gave its explanation in 1923. To explain the shift in wavelengths measured in the experiment, Compton used Einstein's idea of light as a particle. The Compton effect has a very important place in the history of physics because it shows that electromagnetic radiation cannot be explained as a purely wave phenomenon. The explanation of the Compton effect gave a convincing argument to the physics community that electromagnetic waves can indeed behave like a stream of photons, which placed the concept of a photon on firm ground. Have you ever heard of cosmology? The study of cosmology delves into the origin, evolution, and eventual fate of the universe. Beyond just understanding how the universe operates today, cosmology seeks to unlock the very mysteries of its beginning, attempting to piece together an incredibly vast puzzle spanning billions of years. At the heart of cosmology lies the goal to comprehend the universe in its entirety, from the smallest subatomic particles to the vast expanse of cosmic web that stretches across light years. It's a field that synthesizes aspects of astrophysics, particle physics, and astronomy to provide insights into how the universe came to be, how it is expanding, and what it is made of. The journey of cosmology as a science is as fascinating as the cosmos itself. Initially rooted in the realms of philosophy and mythology, cosmology has evolved dramatically with the advancement of technology and observational methods. Here's a brief chronology highlighting this transformation. Ancient cosmology, based largely on myth and speculation, the earliest cosmologies were formed by civilizations such as the Babylonians and Greeks, who offered sophisticated yet untested narratives of the universe's structure. Newtonian cosmology, with the work of Isaac Newton in the 17th century, cosmology took a scientific turn, using mathematics and physics to understand celestial mechanics. Modern cosmology, the 20th century brought significant breakthroughs, including the Big Bang theory and the discovery of cosmic background radiation, which have shaped our current understanding of the universe started and how it evolves. Next fact would be about the Pioneer anomaly. It refers to an unexplained deviation in the trajectories of the Pioneer space probes as they traveled beyond the solar system. The Pioneer anomaly, or Pioneer effect, was the observed deviation from predicted accelerations of the Pioneer 10 and Pioneer 11 spacecraft after they passed about 20 astronomical units on their trajectories out of the solar system. The apparent anomaly was a matter of much interest for many years, but has been subsequently explained by anisotropic radiation pressure caused by the spacecraft's heat loss. Pioneer 10 and 11 were sent on missions to Jupiter and Jupiter, Saturn respectively. Both spacecraft were spin-stabilized in order to keep their high-gain antennas pointed towards Earth using gyroscopic forces. Although the spacecraft included thrusters, after the planetary encounters they were used only for semi-annual conical scanning maneuvers to track Earth in its orbit, leaving them on a long cruise phase through the outer solar system. During this period, both spacecraft were repeatedly contacted to obtain various measurements on their physical environment, providing valuable information long after their initial missions were complete. Because the spacecraft were flying with almost no additional stabilization thrusts during their cruise, it is possible to characterize the density of the solar medium by its effect on the spacecraft's motion. In the outer solar system, this effect would be easily calculable, based on ground-based measurements of the deep space environment. When these effects were taken into account, along with all other known effects, the calculated position of the pioneers did not agree with measurements based on timing the return of the radio signals being sent back from the spacecraft. These consistently showed that both spacecraft were closer to the inner solar system than they should be, by thousands of kilometers, small compared to their distance from the Sun, but still statistically significant. This apparent discrepancy grew over time as the measurements were repeated, suggesting that whatever was causing the anomaly was still acting on the spacecraft. As the anomaly was growing, it appeared that the spacecraft were moving more slowly than expected. Measurements of the spacecraft's speed using the Doppler effect demonstrated the same thing. The observed redshift was less than expected, which meant that the pioneers had slowed down more than expected. When all known forces acting on the spacecraft were taken into consideration, a very small but unexplained force remained. It appeared to cause an approximately constant sunward acceleration for both spacecraft. If the positions of the spacecraft were predicted 1 year in advance based on measured velocity and known forces, mostly gravity, they were actually found to be some 400 kilometers closer to the Sun at the end of the year. This anomaly is now believed to be accounted for by thermal recoil forces. Let's move on to the last fact. Bose-Einstein condensates are states of matter where particles are in the same quantum state, exhibiting remarkable quantum effects at very low temperatures. Unlocking the secrets of the universe often leads to the exploration of mysterious and awe-inspiring phenomena. One such fascinating discovery in physics is the Bose-Einstein condensate, which challenges our understanding of matter and opens up new avenues for scientific exploration. Let's embark on this exciting journey through the world of quantum mechanics and uncover the science behind Bose-Einstein condensate. The Bose-Einstein condensate, BEC, is a state of matter that occurs at incredibly low temperatures, just a few billionths of a degree above absolute zero. At this temperature, a large number of bosons, a type of particle, come together and occupy the lowest quantum state, forming a single entity that behaves as one quantum object instead of a collection of individual particles. This fascinating occurrence was first predicted by Satyendranath Bose and Albert Einstein. That's all for today. I hope this video was interesting and maybe even useful for you. See you soon.